friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session we have seen the iterative statements of C++. So today's session we'll go with the another simple concept, that is conditional statements of C++. Right, so conditional statements. So the name itself indicates, here we'll check the condition, and based upon the result of the condition, we'll execute the statements. So, condition. Condition means it gives a Boolean result. The Boolean result. So, it may be either true or it may be false. Right? So, now what is a condition? So, condition is the relation between two variables. So that means here we will use the relational operator. Relational operators. Right? So that means less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, double is equal to, right? So here we'll go with, let us suppose A and B are the two variables, and we can, if we use this condition, this relational operator in between those two operands, that is called a simple condition. So A less than B, similarly A greater than B, A less than or equal to B, A greater than or equal to B, yeah, similarly A double is equal to B, A not equal to B, right? So all these are the relational operators. So if we are using these relational operators in between two operands, that we call it as a condition. So this result, all these results will be the Boolean result. Boolean result, right? So this we call it as a condition. So everything we call it as a condition. So based upon this condition, based upon the result of this condition, we are going to choose the selection of statements. So which statements are to be executed? So if it is a true, the result of this condition is true, then if block will be executed. If it is a false, else block will be executed, but not both. So remember, but not both. So if block is considered as a true, else block is considered as a false. If it is true, that is represented here as 1. Here it is represented as a 0, right? So if block and else block. Here in conditional statements, we are having three categories of conditional statements. One is simple if. If else. Else if later. So these are the three major things for conditional statements: simple if else, and else if later. So we'll see one by one the syntax of all these things, and then we'll go with the practical orientation. So first one is simple if. So simple if means here only one condition will be given at the if, so that if the condition is true, then only the if block will be executed. That means the control will enter into the if block. So we are not writing any else part. That means if the condition is false, nothing will be done. So for example, the syntax. Syntax for this one is if followed by the condition, and here the block of statements will be again executed. If the condition is true, then only the control will enter into this block. If the condition is false, automatically this will be executed. So condition is true, automatically the control will execute this one. If the condition is false, this one will be executed. This statement will be executed. So these complete statements will be skipped. So all those statements will not get executed. This is called a simple if. So there is no else part. That means we are not writing any false conditions. So only we are going with the true condition. Right? If the condition is true, then only the block will be executed. If it is a false, nothing will happen. we are not writing any code. This is called a simple if. Coming to the if else. If else. So here, if is a true block, else is a false block. So if followed by the condition, it's a block of statements. Else, block of statements. So this is called true block. This is called false block. So based upon this result of this condition, if the condition is true, this block will be executed and this block will be ignored. Right? So at a time, only one block will be executed. The remaining block will be just ignored. All the statements will not get executed. Right? So if the condition is false, then automatically the control will enter into the else block and this part will be executed. This block will be ignored. If block will be ignored and else block will be executed. So this is all about the if else, true block and else block. So at a time, only one block will be executed, but not both. Based upon the result of the condition, the block will be executed. So I will show you the practical orientation in the compiler, right? So we'll see the syntaxes and we'll go with the compiler. Else if ladder. So else if ladder. Coming to this else if ladder, so if the condition is true, so this is mainly used to check for the multiple conditions, to check the multiple conditions, multiple ways. So in the previous one, we are just going with the condition. If it is true, then automatically the else part will be executed. I mean, if it is true, the true block will be executed, otherwise else block will be executed. So if you want to compare, or if you want to check one more condition, if the if condition fails, automatically we will go with the else if. So one thing should be remembered, the condition should not be written in false block. If you want to write one more condition in the false block, then we have to include it as a else if. See, I will show you the example. If followed by the condition, else. So again, if this condition fails, again if you want to check one more condition, here we should not write the condition. If you want to include the condition here, again we have to include if. So this is called else if. Again we have to write the condition here. Similarly, if this condition has also fails, again we can write the another condition, else if condition, and finally we can go with the else block. Right? So if this condition is true, this block will be executed, all the remaining blocks will not get executed. So here also only one block will be executed. If the condition is false, the control comes into the first else if. Again, the control will check for this condition. If this condition is true, this block will be executed and all the remaining blocks will be ignored. If the condition is false, again the control will come to the second else if condition. Right? So like this, the control executes the condition, so on. If all the conditions fails, automatically the else block will be executed. But only one block will be get executed. See, I will write a small example. So if A is equal to B, else if A greater than B, else. See, if you want to compare the variables, two variables, so the relation between two variables can be both are equal, both are not equal, right? So A is greater than B or A is less than B. So first we are checking the condition A is equal to B. If this condition is true, so this block will be executed. If this condition is false, again we are checking for the possible results are A greater than B or A less than B. So again I am checking the condition A greater than B. If this is true, this block will be executed. If this is false, we know that B is greater. So automatically else block will be executed. So if you want to check one more condition, here we have to write again else if condition. So in the else part, we should not write the condition. If you want to write the condition in else block, we have to include if beside the else. So that becomes a else if. So checking for the multiple conditions, this else if ladder will be used. So hope you understood this conditional statements. So we have seen three conditional statements: simple if, if else, and else if ladder. As these conditional statements use the condition, so based upon the result of the condition, the only one block of statements will be get executed. So the result of the condition will be a boolean. That means it will give either true or false. Right? So hope you understood this one. So now we'll see all these things by executing a small program in a compiler. So let's move on to the compiler. Hello friends. So just now we have seen the conditional statements of C++. So in this we have seen the simple if statement, if else, and else if ladder. Now we'll see the practical execution of all these three conditional statements. First, let us include the header file. So in order, if you are using C in and C out for as input and output functions, you have to include iostream.h. If you are using printf and scanf functions as input and output functions, you have to include the stdio.h. On this conio.h. Conio.h is for working of clear screen. The clear screen function, that means clearing all the previous results. Right? Now we'll write the main function. Let us declare a variable a and b. So let us take the value of a and value of b, and let us check the condition. If a is equal to b, we can write c out. Values are equal. This is nothing but a simple if statement. So there will be no else part. So only if condition will be there. So if the condition is true, then only the if block will be get executed. So I am writing the clear screen for clearing all the previous results. So I am condition.cpp. Now let us compile this one. Three errors are there. Okay, sorry. So I have done the redirection mistake. So this is for C in and this is for C out. Okay. Sorry. Yes. So this end L is for end line. Okay. Now, so after successful compilation, I am executing the code. So it is prompting for value A. So I am giving 3 and I am giving B value as 4. So let us check the result, 3 and 4. So nothing is printed because here we are not writing any else part. So if the condition is true, then only the block of statements will be get executed. See, I will write here C out. Enter value of A. C out. Enter value of B. Right. See, I am executing the program.
So enter the value of A, I am giving 3. Enter the value of B, I am giving 3. Now let us check the condition. I mean, like, let us check the output. So values are equal. The result is values are equal because I am giving A as 3 and B as 3. So A is equal to B. Here this double is equal to is nothing but a conditional operator, right? So relational operator. Relational operator means, so comparing two variables and it will result the Boolean result. It will give the Boolean result either true or false. If the condition is true, then only this block of statements will be executed. And if the condition is false, nothing will be executed here. So coming to the L if else, we can write the else part also. So I am writing else part. So if the condition is false, I will write values are not equal. See, this is the else part. So if the condition, if both A and B are equal, then this block will be executed. If the condition is not equal, then this block will be executed. That means this is called a true block and this will be calling as a false block. Now we'll check. So I will execute and check it. So A value is 3 and A B value is 4. Now let us check the result. So values are not equal because 3 and 4 are not equal. So that is, the condition fails, automatically the else block will be executed. So without the if block, we should not write the else block. So if is a true block, else is a false block, right? So now, so this is all about the if and if else. Now we'll see the else if ladder. See, let us compare two things. So here we are checking A is equal to B. If the condition is true, then values are equal. If the condition is false, again I want to check one more condition, A greater than B. A greater than B. So if the A greater than B, then I will write here A is greater, right? And if this condition is also false, again I can write else if A less than B. So here you can write it as B is greater. Right? So like this we can check. Or see, if you check the relation between two operators, either A will be equal to B, or A is greater than B, or A is less than B, right? So we need not go with this statement. If the two conditions are false, automatically this block will be executed. Hope you understood, right? So if this condition is true, this block will be executed. If this condition is false, again we are checking another condition. And if this condition is true, this block will be executed. Again, if this condition is false, automatically the else block will be get executed. That means if A is equal to B is false, then the option is A will be greater than B or A will be less than B. And here we are checking where A is greater than B. And if this condition is also false, automatically that implies B is greater or simply A is smaller. So like this, we can check a multiple conditions, number of conditions we can check. See, I will compile this and I will show you. See, some 3 and a 4. I am giving, I have given the 3 and 4. So B is greater. So B value is 4. A value is 3. So we know that 4 is greater than 3. So first 3 is equal to B. This is false. 3 is greater than B. This is also false. Obviously, the else part will be get executed. So in this conditional statement, only one block will be executed, either if or else. And one thing we have to remember, that we should not write the condition in the else block. See, here I am writing A is equal to B in the if block, and we should not write this in else block. If you want to check again the condition in else block, again we have to include this if. So see, like this, this is a wrong way. Here in this way we should not write. So we should not write any condition in else part. So if we want to again check the condition, we have to include the if, else if. So this is how we can execute the conditional statements. This is how we can use these conditional statements, simple if, else if and else if ladder. So in the else if ladder we can go with the multiple condition checks, but only one block will be get executed. So we can write n number of else if ladders, so else if blocks, so but only one block will be executed, all the remaining will be discarded, right? So if you are having any doubts regarding these conditional statements, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that I will definitely try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my sessions, like my session, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.